For the past few weeks, I've been learning 3D modeling and animation. I am following a great course for beginners, as I have little experience making 3D graphics. Professionally, I am a game programmer. My personal projects have always been in 2D, as I enjoy making pixel art graphics. But I thought that it was time to switch to 3D games. The original plan was to complete the course and learn the basics of 3D modeling and animation, then make a small project. This approach made me lose interest quickly, even though the course is great. So, to fix this, I started remaking my first game, Prisoner. It's a simple action RPG game I made in 2015. I have a video talking about this project and the errors I made. It was my first project and was developed in a month, so errors were made. But don't get me wrong, I'm proud of that game and was the reason to get into game development. Let me go back to 1.5 weeks ago and tell you my process to get here. The course I was following is called Complete Blender Creator 2.8. Learn 3D modeling for beginners. It's a great course to get started into 3D modeling. I will leave a link in the description. As I said, the course is great and all, but I was losing interest. I always thought that the best way to learn something is to try and implement it in a real project. Therefore, I tried to model the protagonist of Prisoner. It's a simple character, but the first attempt were horrible. I tried again, and this time I used reference images and followed this tutorial to model characters. It is in Spanish, but the creator does a great job teaching how to create this sort of characters. So, in the first day of remaking Prisoner, I already had the character. Then, I followed some Intensia tutorials to rig my character. Intensia is a great YouTuber that teaches how to model in low poly and integrate graphics in Unity. I recommend his channel to learn 3D modeling. There is a link in the description. In the second day, I started exporting the graphics to Unity, made a new project and started coding basic movement. But the character had no animations, so I went back to Intensia's channel and started to create a walk, run and idle animations. The good thing about animation is that, if you know how to do it in 2D, you have some theory to speed up the process in 3D. For example, I already knew concepts like anticipation, weight and keyframes. And thanks to Intensia's channel, I quickly made some decent animations. Then, it was time to import them to Unity and make a basic animator for the character. It was great to have the character moving in a level I made with ProBuilder, but I needed to create more animations for the main mechanic of Prisoner, attacking. As I said, I'm trying to fix some issues with the original game, so I thought about making an evasion mechanic. Prisoner didn't let you dodge attacks, resulting in more deaths than necessary, and the gameplay became really repetitive after a few minutes, although the game is only like 20 minutes long. By the way, if you want to play the original game, there is a link in the description. It's totally free. As I was saying, a roll animation would let me implement a dodge mechanic in the remake. I am not too convinced about the current animation, that the system is in place. I also added some particle effects to the sword, so it would leave a trail when the character attacks. The next day, I spent some time making new attack animations, so the character could do chain attacks. If the player press attack when the sword leaves a trail, the character will chain a second attack. And that attack also has a chain attack, leading to a powerful slash. The game was starting to have a good feeling, but something was missing. Sound effects. I made a simple sound effect manager to handle this. With animation events, I managed to add sounds to the roll, attack and even the walk and run animations of the character. Prisoner aesthetic is pretty simple. The character is imprisoned in a castle, so there is a lot of stone walls and cells. I tried to make some modular tiles so I can build a test level. To start, I only made one floor and one wall tile. They were not bad, but I thought I could do better. So looking back to the course I told you earlier, I saw a section about making a modular dungeon. It was exactly what I needed to create levels in Prisoner Remake. I don't know how I missed it. By the way, this section of the course is taught by Grant Abbott, another great YouTuber to learn 3D modeling. As always, there is a link in the description. What's even better about Grant Abbott's approach to the modular dungeon is that I can create different dungeons with a few tiles. I will probably change these modules in the future, as I gain more experience in 3D modeling. But for the time being, it's a great foundation. Another part I am learning while I make this game is lighting. It's overwhelming how hard lighting a scene is, but it's also a lot of fun. I need to create a dark, mysterious atmosphere for the Prisoners remake. The original game has this fog effect where you can only see what's near the player and light sources, such as enemies or torches. I don't plan to remake this mechanic, but I would love to have some sections when the environment is really dark, and add some sort of stealth mechanic to the game. But we will see about that. That's my progress on Prisoners remake so far. What do you think? 3D modeling was always confusing to me, but I think that learning it this way is the right choice. I will make more videos showing the progress of the game. If you have any suggestions for the remake, leave a comment below. And don't forget to subscribe and activate notifications so you won't miss any new updates. Hope you enjoyed the video. See you next time!